Okay, so today we're going to solve heat conduction with a nuclear heat source. Okay, so you just have a cylinder that's filled with a nuclear source, and then you have a layer of aluminium cladding. So the temperature distribution would be the T of the nuclear source at this point, and it drops all the way to the temperature of the cladding, which is TC, and finally it again drops the temperature outside, which is T0. Now this radius can be taken as R of F, and this radius can be taken as R of C. So here we also know that the volumetric the volume rate of the heat production can be taken as Sn is equal to Sn0, 1 plus P Rf whole raised to 2. This is important because this means that it is a function of R, which is expected. This is only in the inner portion and not the outer portion, because the outer portion would be just aluminium cladding. So let's take the heat balance across, after considering a small sphere of a radius R, the inner section and a width of delta R. So at R, the heat entering would be equal to Q of R at 4 pi R square. R is equal to R, the heat exiting would be Q of R 4 pi R plus delta R the whole square. Delta is equal to R plus delta R. Now we are assuming that this delta R is so small that we can just take it as minus Q 4 pi R square R plus delta R. And the total volume that is generated to this would be 4 pi R square into delta R into SO, that is the amount of heat that's generated. Now just taking a balance of this, so just be, you can take the balance and divide the whole thing by 4 pi delta R, and you get QR into R plus delta R minus QR the whole to R square by delta R is equal to SC R square. Now here you have just moved this to the left hand side the other time so that you can get R plus delta R minus R. Now this can be taken as dQR by dR, this is sorry R square is equal to SC R square. And you also know this is for QR if it is inside, and if it's for the outside portion you can just take it as QC R square dR, but there's no heat generation so it's just zero. Because aluminium cladding by itself does not generate any heat. Okay, and now you know what SE stands for. And substituting that, you get d by dr r square q r f is equal to SNO 1 plus p r by rf whole squared into r square. Sorry about that. Yeah, so that basically just means that R square QR D by DR into SNO into R square plus P R is to 4 R squared. This is for QR R square QRF, and the other one will be just R square QF DR is equal to 0. So you can integrate both of these. The first one would give you R square QR is equal to SNO R3 by 3 plus R5 by 5 plus C1, and the second one would give you just R square QR, this is inside the fictional fictitious material, and this one would be the cladding part, so would just be C1. Now you can just move them to the other side. QRF is equal to SNO R by 3 plus BR3 by 5 plus C1 by R square, and this will just be QRC is equal to C1 by R square. Now let's use some boundary conditions to find out what this is. C1C and this is C1F. Okay, so what we do know is one is that R is equal to 0, QR F cannot be infinite. So if QR F cannot be infinite, that means C1 must be equal to 0. Okay, what else do we know? And we know that at R is equal to RF, QRF must be equal to QRC. So on substituting this as well, you'll be able to find the value for C1. And now you can just substitute these two values into your equation. And you get QRF is equal to SNO R3 plus B RF2 R cubed by 5, and this would just be again the same. So no 1 plus 3 plus B5 plus R F3 by R square. Okay, and now you can substitute these two as one as KF DT by DR. This is KC DT by DR. And this is just here you'll be using the same terms. And now you can just differentiate both of these with respect to R, and you will get, let's write this down. TF is equal to minus SNO KF plus R squared by 6 plus RF squared R raised to 4. Sorry about that. C4 by 20 plus C2, and this would be TC is equal to SNO KC 1 by 3 plus K R cube R plus C2. And you also know that R at RF would be equal to TF is equal to TC, and R at RC should be equal to TC is equal to T0. And you can just input these two into the problem and you will be getting the result for the temperature distribution across the material which is undergoing fusion, and also the aluminium cladding should give you the temperature for both of them. Okay, let's see the next problem in the next video.